Hi, welcome to online digital marketing training. In this video, I'm going to explain about conversion tracking in AdWords. See, you're spending amount on AdWords. People are clicking on your ads. They're coming to your website. But if you don't track how many of them converted, it's waste. So return on investment, you have to track, right? So that is called conversion tracking over here. But first understand, what do you mean by a conversion? Someone tell me, what do you mean by conversion?
Change.
So I'll tell you, you've been to Amazon website. What do you mean by conversion for Amazon website? Purchase the product is the conversion for them. If customer come here, he clicked on your ad, 30 rupees rejected. Once he do window shopping, it's not correct. He has to purchase. It's a conversion. Now ODMT website is there. For me, what is the conversion? Mine is not product based enrollment. Again, I don't have any payment gateway. For me, what is conversion is customer fill the form, then it's a conversion. How does it know that customer fill the form? Just try to understand that. So customer come here, he mentioned the details here. Then send button. So generally it will be there in odmt.in, some other page will be there. From wherever he is, he fill the form, it will redirect to one page, that to the thank you page. Can you see here?
Yes.
It's going to a thank you page. Okay. Again, I already taught you how to create a website, how to create contact form. But once you create a contact form in your website, let me show you, spend some time. You have a contact form in your website? Who have a contact form? What's your website? What?
DAMA.
That's one. Damage DNA. It's recording. People come to your website. Right. So I'll show this website. His contact form is there, but it's not customized properly. So I'm filling the details here. Now where we are, damage DNA.xyz. Then CAPTCHA is there. I'm clicking on send button. Okay, so problem, we have a problem. Okay, let me show one more website. So this is another website where I'll show you what happens with the contact form actually. So we have here. Subject only this is. So not done properly. Then send button. We are in the main URL. When you click on send button, thank you for contact is bol ke aaya. But this is not a thank you page. We're still in the same page. If your contact form set it like this, you can't track conversions. It has to redirect to the thank you page. But how to create a thank you page? It is there on my video. So go to YouTube and type ODMT thank you page. You'll be getting that. So how to create thank you page in WordPress. So go through this video, you'll understand how to set up a thank you page. That is mandatory. Before you do conversion tracking for any website, this is mandatory. See, my website already thank you page set. Now you tell me, 100 people clicked on my ad, 20 people came to thank you page. What does it mean? 20 people fill the form. Is there any chance that you can go to thank you page directly without filling a form? No, right? There is no link here. You can't go to thank you page directly. You fill the form, then only go to thank you page. Means simply, I can identify that 20 people converted. Same Amazon website also. Once you add the product, buy from debit to credit card, you'll go to thank you very much, order received. Can you go to that page directly? You can't go. You've been there means conversion happened. So in Google AdWords, Google Ads, there is a code actually. Conversion tracking code will be there. Take that code, put it in this page. Only in thank you page you have to put it. Then whenever come to this page, that tracking code will tell you that already one conversion happened. This is how we'll track the conversion. And you can also mention the tracking value also. How much profit we got also we can mention. That I'm going to show you. But remember that different website categories have a different conversion. E-commerce website, purchase is a conversion. My kind of education website, lead is a conversion. You have a blog, there will be no lead, there will be no purchase. customer spend some time, 30 minutes, it's a conversion. That is also you can track. Some website customer played a video, that is also a conversion. As of now, I'm showing you lead, how to track a conversion as a lead. So in order to track the conversion, there is an option called tools on the top right side. Click on the tools. Under measurement, there is an option called conversion. Can you see this? Click on conversion. First time we're doing here. See how Google Ads help you achieve your goals. Conversion tracking helps you see which keywords, ads, ad groups, and campaigns drive the customer actions you care about. Purchases, subscriptions, app installs, phone calls, and more. Click on the plus conversion. You can track website conversions, app conversions, phone calls, and offline conversions also. Okay, as of now, I'm showing website conversions. Remaining things I'll show you in a later video. Website conversion. Yeah, it's asking what is your category? What is your category? Purchase, lead, page view, sign up, or other? It's a lead, a person interested in a product or service, share contact information. Conversion name. You write your conversion name. So, contact form. Value. You can give the same value. You can give a different value. You don't have to use the value. But what I feel is, if you use the value, that's much better. So, here's some mathematics I'm going to teach you. If it is an e-commerce website, customer purchased, you'll come to know how much profit you got it. Assume that same kind of product you're selling. Assume that you're selling the pen drives. Pen drive cost is, assume that $1. And assume that you're getting $0.80 of profit. So you can mention clearly here, right? I'm getting $0.80. He purchased. But when it comes to ODMT website, he filled the form. He filled the form, it doesn't mean that he joined, right? He didn't join. Then it can't be a conversion. At the time, we will take approximate value. Just understand this. These are the 5 students. According to me, what I feel is, with my experience, every 5 students fill the form, one person is pakka joining. We got a 5 leads. When our counselor is talking to them, because of the price issue, blah blah blah, because of the timing issue, one person is pakka joining. Out of 5, 1. Total 10 people came, right? So here one guy joined, here one guy joined. As of now, how much amount I'm taking for online course? I'm taking 20,000. Here I got 20,000 and here also I got 20,000. But who gave 20,000 here? You don't know. Whether this guy, this guy, this guy, this guy, you don't know. Here also. But one person definitely gave. But what Google says, each person fill the form, assign some value. He's not giving you money. Only this, assume that this guy only paying money. But for this guy also assign a value, this guy also value, this guy also you have to assign a value. Make sure that it should be 20,000 again. Then how much value you want to give for the each customer?
4,000.
Very good. For this guy 4,000, 4,000, 4,000, 4,000, 4,000. Overall 20,000. So it's not going anything else. So everything is accurate. So according to my analysis, out of every 5 students, one guy is joining. But when it comes to Google, the algorithm is in such a way that each time you have to assign a value. At the time, take a average amount. Okay, 4,000 is the right answer. So let me do the same thing. So use the same value for each conversion. And here, I'm giving it as a 4,000 rupees. Not required. Here, how much amount is spending, how much profit you got, that's it. We don't require the people name. So, return on investment, it will be due. If it is e-commerce website, automatically it will be done anyway. Done. Again, this is important. Count. One customer filled 3 times. Will he join 3 times? Then do I have to count everyone or one? One only have to convert. So recommended for lead, signups and other conversions, because only the first interaction is valuable. Okay. You're tracking leads. Someone clicks your ad and enters their information twice. on your website, only one commerce is reported. Now think about e-commerce website. You came, you purchased three products. At that time, is it every product or one product? It's every, because every time is paying money. So depends on which you can select it. So here one only. Conversion window 30 days, it's saying that. Understand this. Conversion can happen days after a person interacts with your ad. Select the maximum time after an ad interaction that you want to count conversion. Today customer clicked, immediately he didn't purchase the product. But within 30 days, whenever he purchased, still it's counted as a conversion only. Cookies will be there. Okay. Maximum, it can be 90 days. You can put 1 day, 2 day, maximum 90 days. It's up to you anyway, how many days you want to count down. So these are not required as of now. Later I'll tell you. That's it. So how to do conversion tracking? Before that, conversion means e-commerce website purchases a conversion. For my kind of website, lead is a conversion. So first understand what is the conversion. Then click on tools option. Under measurement, there is an option called conversion. Then click on plus symbol. Then you'll be getting a window. You have to type the conversion name, which category it is, what is the conversion name, value how much, take the average, count one, conversion window, then create and continue. Then here you have access to the website, install the tag by yourself. You have a developer, give it to the developer. One more option is the tag manager that you're going to learn later. Now this is the code. Actually you have to place this code. But in order to work this code, there is one more code called global site tag. This you will use for Google Analytics anyway. It's already there, not required. Just paste this code. Okay. In the next video, someone watching my Google Analytics one, you will understand. Till now, you haven't put any code. Do one thing. First, take this code, put it in a head section. Head section means it's appearing for every page. It will track your performance also, each page. At the same time, this is helpful for remarketing. Remarketing means people came to this website, he didn't purchase, you can target them. Now for me, if customer come to thank you page, then only conversion, right? There will be another code here. This code, where you have to paste? Thank you. You have to paste it in a thank you page. So the event snippet works with the global site tag to track actions that should be counted as a conversion. Choose whether to track conversion on page or load. Copy the snippet below and paste it in between the pages which you would like to track. But see, it is a WordPress, you don't have to paste it in a head section. Directly go to that page, take the short code and paste it. Take the short code and paste it. So next I'm going to show one live subject, live practical website. There I'll show practically. As of now, understand the concept only. Okay. That's it guys, this is about conversion tracking. So remaining conversions I'll be explaining in the next video. Thank you very much.